Let me ask you, have you ever felt like your Avata 2 is a bit sluggish? Kind of like she's dragging her heels, a bit floaty and drifty, like a leaf on the wind? Well, this one is for you, because today we're going to talk about tuning your gain and exposure so you can get that buttery tight control and that confidence when flying full manual. I'm Adam from Drone & Lens, and if you've been here before, welcome back. If this is your first time, smash that like button and hit subscribe, as it really helps my channel grow. Now, let's get right into it. Now, out of the box, the stock rates on this thing are a bit meh. They're a bit floaty, too drifty, like it's dragging its heels, kind of stuck in the mud. But with a few tweaks, the Avata 2 becomes a whole different beast. Smoother, snappier through bends, and way more precise. And I'm gonna show you how to do it. What are your rates anyway? Your rates control how fast your drone responds to your stick inputs when it comes to pitching, rolling, and yawing. In other words, how twitchy or how chill your drone is in the air. Now, to adjust them on the FPV controller, we need to go to settings, we need to move to control, and then remote controller. Now, when we're here, we're gonna bounce all the way over to gain and exposure. Now, this is where the magic happens. Now, let's break down these settings. Center stick sensitivity. This is all about precision. It controls how sensitive the drone is from when you just start moving the stick in this little sensitive position right in the center. Now, the lower the value, the smoother movement it's gonna produce from the drone. It's gonna be less twitchy, more floaty. And the higher the value, well then, that's quicker. More tiny input, it's gonna be a lot more snappier. Personally, I fly a lot of cinematic shots, so I keep all three of these settings at 150 for consistency. This gives me the fine touches I need for tight gaps or smooth motion without overcorrecting on the sticks. So now we're going to talk about max rates. This is how fast your drone can spin in each direction in the air, and it's measured by degrees per second. Now, the stock roll and pitch is set to 450, but this feels like it's really dragging its heels. So for me, you want to crank that up. So when I punch out of a tight spot or I roll into a flip, I want it snappy, I don't want it delayed. So what we want to do is we want to crank that roll to 600. We want to crank your pitch to 550. And we want that yaw at 600 as well. And we'll talk about that in just a second. Now we're gonna talk about Expo. Expo smooths out the response curve of your sticks. So small movement equals small, softer drone reactions. Now if you push them big stick throws, that's when you'll end up with the bigger reaction. Just think of it as a curve on a graph. When you're going up, the small reactions keeps everything tight and nimble. But DJI actually got this part right. I actually do like the way this Expo is set up, so I don't actually touch the Expo. I keep that the same and constant all the way through, because I'm actually happy with that. You may feel the same. Here's what it looks like in action. You can see in this first clip, this is me performing little loops and gaps between these trees. I mean, yeah, it's okay, but it's a bit floaty looking. Here's the same situation, but with me more tuned up. As you can see, I'm pulling these gaps a lot tighter, these turns are a lot sharper, and I'm a lot more confident banking around these trees. This is all down to the fine-tuned setup of your gain and exposure. Now, let's talk straight up yaw. Straight away, out of box, yaw was awful. Felt like I had to yank these sticks all the way over just to get it to bank and turn. Now that's not ideal when you're trying to frame your shot correctly and also avoid the tree. This is why I match me yaw with me roll rate exactly the same. This yaw reacts just how I expect it to, quick, clean, and a lot more control. Here's a quick recap on your gain and exposure settings. If you want a more nippier and quicker reacting drone, then you should input these settings as is. So you want your center sensitivity at 150, same as always. And then you want that max rate at 600. Remember, if you're pushing it all the way to the max, that's when you're going to get 600 degrees per second. Think about that. So if you want to use the settings I use, don't worry, I've made a clickable link in the description to a downloadable PDF that you can save on your phone or your tablet, no problem. And you've got them settings there to reference each and every time. Tuning your rates isn't just about your drone's feel, it's also about your confidence. Now, when this drone starts moving exactly how you want it to, just you watch, you're going to start flying more defensively and you're going to start flying a hell of a lot more creatively. Now, these settings gave me the control and they'll do the same for you if you're confident enough to let it. So my advice is that when you change these settings yourself, go out to a clear field and give yourself a battery pack or two just to get used to the feel of this more snappier, responsive drone. Now, if you want to see how these rates perform, do me a favor, smash that subscribe button and check out other flights on my channel. I'm Adam from Drone and Lens. You guys have been colorful. Stay up, stay flying, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. I just wanted to say thank you for watching. And if you got any type of value whatsoever from this video, please hit that like button and smash subscribe, as it helps me in more ways than you could imagine. Now get out there and get flying, and I'll see you in the next one.